Hello friends, welcome to Easy Academy. In this lecture, let us understand the introduction to digital modulation techniques. In digital communication, there are basically two types of transmission of digital signals. First one is baseband transmission and second one is passband transmission. In baseband transmission, the digital data is transmitted over a channel directly, which means there will be no carrier signal and there will be no modulation. This type of transmission is suitable for shorter distance. So baseband is not applicable for longer distance communication. In passband transmission, the high frequency sinusoidal carrier signal is modulated using the digital data. Hence, a high frequency sinusoidal carrier signal is digitally modulated. This type of transmission are suitable for transmission over a longer distance. Now, if we consider the digital modulation, we can classify the digital modulation into three basic types. First one is PSK, which is phase shift keying. Second one is FSK, which is frequency shift keying. And third one is ASK, which is amplitude shift keying. So we can define digital modulation. Digital modulation is a technique that uses discrete signal to modulate a carrier wave. If we take this digital data as an example, where we are considering 1011001 that need to be transmitted. Now let us consider the first type of digital modulation technique, which is phase shift keying. In phase shift keying, digital data modulates the phase of the carrier signal. If you observe here, when there is a transition from 1 to 0, there is a phase shift of 180 degree in a carrier signal. Again, when there is a transition from 0 to 1, there is a phase shift of 180 degree. And if you observe this modulated signal, there is no phase shift when you are having the same sequence of data. So we are having 1 and 1, so there is no phase shift. For 0 and 0, again there is no phase shift. The second type of digital modulation is frequency shift keying. In frequency shift keying, the digital data modulates the frequency of the carrier signal. So frequency of the carrier signal will be modulated. When there is a transition from 1 to 0, you can see the frequency of carrier signal is varied here. Again, when there is a transition from 0 to 1, there is a variation in frequency of the carrier signal. When we are having the same sequence like 11 and 00, there will be no change in frequency of the carrier signal. Hence, there will be change in frequency of a carrier signal only when there is different sequence of data. Third type of digital modulation technique is amplitude shift keying. In this technique, the digital data modulates the amplitude of the carrier signal. So if you observe here, when there is 1, there is no variation in the carrier signal. When there is 0, there is no signal. Again for 1, you will be having a carrier signal. And for 0, there is no signal. Again for 1, we are having the signal. If you observe here, the amplitude of the carrier signal is varied with respect to the sequence. If 1 is there, there will be a carrier signal, and for 0, the amplitude of the carrier signal is made as 0. So these three are the basic types of digital modulation techniques. Now let us understand the type of reception of data in case of passband transmission. There are two types of methods of detection of passband signals. First one is coherent detection, which is also known as synchronous detection. Second one is non-coherent detection, which is also known as envelope detection. In coherent detection method, the local carrier, which is generated at the receiver, and the carrier signal at the transmitter will be phase locked. If we say phase lock, which means the frequency of oscillation of the carrier at the receiver will constantly adjust to match with the frequency of the carrier at the transmitter. So the carrier at the receiver will adjust to the frequency of the carrier at the transmitter. Such type of process is known as phase lock. So in coherent detection, we can say the carrier at the receiver and the carrier signal at the transmitter are phase locked. In non-coherent detection, the local carrier at the receiver and the carrier at the transmitter are not phase locked. Such type of transmission we will call that as non-coherent detection, or it is also known as envelope detection. Coming to the advantages of passband transmission, we can use passband transmission for longer distance communication. There is no problem of crosstalk in the signal. We can use analog channels for transmission. Also, it is very much helpful for wireless communication using wireless channels. And for transmission, we are having many modulation techniques. Coming to the disadvantages, compared to other system, the system is complex and passband transmission is not suitable for shorter distance communication. This is about the introduction to digital communication techniques. Hope you have understood the topic. Thank you.